Welcome back to my English class. Today we are going to learn the pond, the land of storybooks. In the previous class, we learned that the speaker in this poem is a young child. He is describing his evening rituals here. So today we are going to study the next 8 lines of the poem. Take your text and listen carefully. Okay. There in the night, where none can spy, all in my hunter's camp I lie and play at books that I have read till it's time to go to bed. There in the night, where none can spy, all in my hunter's camp I lie and play at books that I have read till it's time to go to bed. Children, the child in this poem has created his own world of imagination through the books that he has read. He appreciates all those adventures one might engage in within the pages of the book. Now, the child is in the hunter's camp. And where is the hunter's camp? Yes, behind the sofa. He says that none can spy him. What do you mean by spy? Spy means to gather secrets or information. So, the child says that no one can see him or gather information about him. In the hunter's camp, behind the sofa, the child reads the book. He spends every evening like this. Unfortunately, it's time to go to bed. So, the child rereads the passages and traces out the most exciting scenes and all the places he visits within the pages of the book. Clear? Now, let's move to the next answer. These are the hills, these are the woods, these are my starry solitudes, and they are the river by whose brink the roaring lions come to drink. These are the hills, these are the woods, these are my starry solitudes, and they are the river by whose brink the roaring lions come to drink. So children, in these lines, we can see that crouching away from his family, the boy explores hills and woods. Woods means forest. He visits all these places alone. You see, starry solitude. What do you mean by solitude? Solitude means moments when one is happy to be alone. He visits all these places alone. No one else in his home or from the outside can explore these places. It is in these places that he is the happiest child. He can also see a river from which a roaring lion comes to drink water. Can you see? The boy can see so many dangerous faraway places without leaving his camp. And where is his camp? Yes, behind the sofa. Actually, the child is playing in his home and he imagines all these things. Okay. Now I am going to read the text once again. Listen carefully. There in the night where none can spy, all in my hunter's camp I lie and play at books that I have read till it's time to go to bed. These are the hills, these are the woods, these are my starry solitudes, and there the river by whose brink the roaring lions come to drink. Now, let's watch the video.
There in the night where none can spy, all in my hunter's camp I lie and play at books that I have read till it is time to go to bed. These are the hills, these are the woods, these are my starry solitudes, and there the river by whose brink the roaring lions come to drink.
Hope you have understood. That's all for today. See you in the next class. Bye.